Okay, it's July 24th, 2018. It's 10:42 a.m. And we haven't had no rain for about 6 days. So for the first time this morning, I should have done this every 5 days, but I didn't. I came out here and watered, especially back in the back by the watermelon and the cantaloupe. This is the okra. We've got 5 burgundy okra, and there's a green one's kind of like eclipse inside here. Move this branch right there. You can see that green one right there. It's got any okra on there. No, it's a busted leaf, a busted branch, whatever you want to call it. But there's fresh growth. This one here, this green okra. My wife was out here earlier. She might have cut some off because there was quite a few on here. No, yeah, she did. But look at the bees going inside the flowers. And the big wing butterflies, the large wing butterflies are out here. There's 3, 4. There's a yellow one that's usually out here too. Not the same one, I wouldn't think. Perhaps it is, but. Yeah, zucchini. Oh, look at this one. I watered this down. See, that's about the size you'd buy in the store right there, that yellow zucchini. We let them get a little bit larger than that. We have gotten some small ones, but there's one down there. I don't know if you can see that one. It's like a yellowish color. Let me see with my cane. Right there. There's one right there. Okay, that's the zucchini out here. Again, there's 6 out here. 4 spots, because 2 of the spots got 2 zucchini growing out of them. So, again, you see that yellow green one right there. Should be yellow, that's why I'm seeing the green, and I was wondering about that. But anyway, the green is supposed to be over here on this side. 2 holes with green, 2 holes with yellow. Torch. This right here, let me turn around, is up to my shoulders. That's like the orange ones back there. That's where all the large winged butterflies, hummingbirds, and honeybees get on them all the time. That's why they're out here. And this for the bees. The watermelon, cantaloupe, and honeydew are right here. Look at this. About another 4 weeks, that's it. And then I'm going to start pulling this up and putting my beans over here. Maybe a good week or two into August. I mean, you know, by the end of August is when I pull these up, and then maybe wait until the last few days of August and plant a bunch of beans out here to go from south to north. And as you can see right here, we've got 3 in the house right now. We've got 1 or 2 in the freezer and 1 or 2 cut up into pieces in the refrigerator. So we got more than enough cantaloupe and honeydew. Actually, mainly cantaloupe. I think I've only seen like 2 honeydews out here. They're the smooth green looking. The rest of them are cantaloupe. There's like 1 plant must be a honeydew right here. See that? It looks like a pistachio. See that smooth skin, yellowish? There's another one right there. There's another one. It's a bigger one. That's about the size of the cantaloupe you get in the store right there. No, actually, that's a little bit bigger than the ones in the store. A little bit bigger than that's what you get in the store. That's a honeydew. That's a honeydew. The cantaloupes you get in the store are a little bit smaller than that. So there's 2 honeydews out here, and the rest are either cantaloupe or watermelon, sugar baby watermelon. I thought I had the long watermelon too, but I guess not. There's a sugar baby. That may be bad. There's a cantaloupe, or there's a watermelon. 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 And then all those in there, you can see them, are cantaloupe, I believe. Watermelon right there. There's a cantaloupe ready to be picked. There's one growing there. There's one there. There's one right there. Like I said, you see them right down there, the smaller ones, that one and that one. But see, I hadn't been watering these like I had in the past. I would water it every 4 or 5 days maximum. And this year, for some reason, I just wasn't doing that. We had a couple of rains from the spring up, pop-up showers that we had with the heat. We've had major heat. But you see the grass around the edges is too high too. Again, next year, over here, I don't know what I'm going to do next year, but it won't be watermelon, cantaloupe. Tomatoes will be over where the okra is at right now. And but again, everything, like I said, each year I keep saying we need to go further away from the edges, and I still put these too close to the edge. And like I say, it grows out a little bit north, and all that high grass, like this high grass right here, it's hard to cut the grass that way without killing, hitting the plant too. And there's a nice big basil. I gave these water. There's an eggplant, basil, eggplant. That one, I don't know if that's gonna make it. Might make it. I make up some proto grow that I have, basil. Okay, now it's about 56 feet across from east to west, west to, going to east. These with the sticks in right now are seeds. I just put seeds of pepper plants, which I don't look forward to them to grow that way out here. Usually you grow a plant and then you get them planted out here like you do your tomatoes. But the peppers, that's what we did right there. And you can see how small that one is still. That's been out here for about 3 weeks. We planted peppers here, nothing. Planted one there and look how small it is. If you can see it even on the screen. There's a green pepper in there. I mean a green plant of a pepper. Okay, see, I'm on the last third of the garden here. And again, you can see the cantaloupe. And over here, cantaloupe. And the cucumbers are mixed in here. Usually the pointed leaves are your cucumbers. Oh, right here. I'm sorry, I passed them. Right here is the pointed leaves. These are for the cucumbers. We just gave away 3 or 4 of them to a neighbor. And I don't know if I can see any right now. Usually you see them, they look like little sweet pickles, eh? But they're mixed in there too. They plant them right where this thing right here, this tomato steak. There's another plant somewhere in this area too that's coming up right there where that little wooden tomato steak is. And you can see how they're coming out. That's cucumbers. Okay, that's just beyond the halfway mark of the middle of the number 3 garden. So we got about four cucumber plants here. And I had planted so many, I may have overplanted them actually. I get over exuberant about it. Just plant 1 or 2 seeds, maximum 2 seeds, and they grow. See, look at all these, that's what I'm saying, look at all these. There's one right there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See how they're overtaking the tomatoes right here? These look to be like cherry tomatoes too, right there. And right over here. I picked a few of these cherry tomatoes over here and ate a couple of them. See, I can eat these right off the vine. See that little red one there? You know, you can eat them when they're orangish color, okay, but I mean, I have two, but they're not getting ripe because I'm gonna pick this one off and eat this one. See this one here? I can't see the viewfinder, so just right here. Oh man, pretty good. You can see the hole down there. Another one here, but see how this melon plant is overtaking it? This is a tomato plant right here. See that? But it's getting buried by this, see this? Here's my cane to get up on top. See the melon plant goes right into it and covers it up, kills it, snuffs it out. See, here's a tomato plant was put out here about 3 weeks ago also. The heat is one thing because, you know, I haven't been watering it like I should have. This one too. Putting out tomatoes. These are all about the size of, I can't think of it. About a pool ball. If you ever played pool billiards, that's about the size of these tomatoes right here. I was hoping for the ones they I on the packet said for about a pound, but again, look at this because of brown spot. Look at those plants. Look at the leaves are off them because of the brown spot that's on these trees out here that get over here in these heirloom gardens. You can see the leaves how they're. Let me see if I can zoom in on that. See stuff like that. You're supposed to peel that off, and I hadn't been doing that, but with the heat, it makes it impossible to really get out here and keep up on it. But I was peeling that off, trying to do that the best I could, but it got to the point where, like I said, look at how these are. It looks like Charlie Brown's Christmas tree. That was a plum tomato plant right here. Look at how few leaves are left down there. There were 2 tomatoes on there. I got one in the house. Oh, there's one down there. Oh, that's from this plant here. What the heck? Is that tied onto there? Oh, wow. It's mingled into this one here. But there's a tomato right there. That's from this plant. See, look at that little one right there. I mean, they're just not growing right here. These others came out, but then you get the brown spot on them, and then that's all it takes, and it takes over. And man, I tell you, all this crap around here, because I blame it directly on the Monsanto
product around us, you know, because why else? They grow fairly well, then they come out here and they spray all their crap, and within about 2 weeks or so, then all this is happening in my plants. I had some flowers out here blocking them, and they ran over some of them already over there, and they're too far back. Next year it's going to be about maybe two widths of a lawnmower off of my garden over this way. I'm not sure if my wife says not to put one over here, because look at all the grass, how that grass is. But again, you got it's a trade-off, I guess, too, to a point. You got to have some barrier if at all possible. Yeah, you know, those beans back there, purple hull peas, black-eyed peas, and a different heirloom bean or pea right over there in that corner. I'm going to use them right out of the pack. I've got cannoli or canola. It's cannoli, and then there's a. Oh boy, what's the other one's name now? It's all these weird heirloom names of beans. It's a white bean. That's what's going to be all the way from the west end coming this way, going northward. But see, now I planted all those like this here. See how close this is to the edge? And that's how that is right there with all the grass on it. So this would be about the closest. I'll do it right here. This is about 5 feet into the plastic. And just, if I have to, I'll make holes. Make holes, you know, going down that way. 5 feet in from the plastic. And they don't have to be real far apart. I don't even know what the recommended distance is. But from here, I would go about here, which is 4 feet across. It's about 4 feet apart. So I could probably get a lot of beans in here. And I plant those like the last week of August. And then we got September, October into November, which, you know, It won't frost until the end of November. The first frost is usually like the 20th of November. And if it did frost, it would be a light frost. It wouldn't be enough to hurt the plants. So by the end of October, we'll be picking all the beans and stuff. Right now, we got quite a few out there, black-eyed peas and purple hull peas. We've been picking those too. But let me get off this place. But see, again, it's so hard because my knees, my wife's ankles and her hip, and we're not having anybody else do it. We're trying to do it ourselves. Yeah, the tomatoes won't be over here next year. They'll probably be back where they were a year before last or 2 years ago over there with peppers. Hopefully we get peppers. I've got to still try growing some peppers. I'm going to plant. I got two peppers growing in a long pot. And I'm going to plant them out here where I had those other peppers maybe. I mean, I don't know what else to do. I clear off this grass right down here maybe and put a pepper in there, plant down there. Peppers and tomatoes generally together grow well. There's a spot right there in the middle. Put a pepper in there. And I got another one back there where that hole is right there. Put a pepper plant in there. And we'll just hope for the best, you know.